One thing for which I shall always remember Pillow Talk was the difficulty in getting guests to come on. For every person you actually saw, there were about 483 people approached who'd say, "No way am I getting into bed with that girl." One particularly difficult time was the last week of December 1987, when through various people dropping out and everyone being away for Christmas, we had to accept two members of a new pop group. As they'd done nothing, I had no press cuttings on which to base any questions, but at least they were keen. So keen, they arrived 3.5 hours early. They don't arrive anywhere 3.5 hours too early anymore. They don't do any interviews anymore. I wonder why. Talk of 1988, and to celebrate, I'm in bed with not one, but two men, which is pretty exciting, and they're so incredibly young that they brought their teddy bears along with them, which is quite sweet.
Hello.
Hello.
Very nice to see you here with your teddies. Your names, correct me if I'm wrong, bugger it up at this point, yeah. Matthew and Luke. That's very good indeed. And you two are two out of the three members of this new group, Goss, which we keep hearing about. You're going to be the next Wham, da 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 da, and all that sort of stuff. Is this true?
We hope so.
Like it to be.
You hope it is. Do you reckon it will be? Being absolutely honest, is it really going to actually make as much a sensation as you keep saying it will?
It's going to happen.
Couldn't really say anything else, could you?
No, not really.
You've got a new single out, which is called I Want to Be Famous. It's called When Will I Be Famous? And that seems to be a bit of a sort of fixation with the two of you, from all stuff I've read about you.
Yeah.
I'll stop playing with you, Teddy, a second.
Sorry.
That's right. Is it very important for you two to be famous?
No, it's important to be successful, because like, we've been at it since we were 12. But, I mean, the actual, like, to be famous, it's like that, not like, oh, God, we've got to be
famous. Was it written about us, was it?
No, the song. It's written about a girl who wants
to be famous. Us when she's been famous.
But you are singing it and everything, so.
We're singing it, but she's asking, it's about a girl who's asking us.
Oh, I see. Didn't actually come across.
Wasn't wishful thinking when it is.
I'm sorry.
But is it an important thing to you? I mean, obviously you want to be successful, but the actual whole fame thing, is that not something that you want?
Yeah, definitely. We want part of that, but I think it's like, if you just say, oh, we want to be famous, I mean, you're going to be like 2 minute wonders. We want to be successful as musicians as well as
if we're successful, then we'll be famous as well. We don't say famous, we'll be successful.
You have been at it since you were 12, and when you first formed that famous pop group, Caviar.
Oh, no! listen, I just found out.
Where did you get that?
Wolfelswick, right? And she used to go to the Bell Inn to drink.
Oh, thank you very much. Okay, I've done my research on you, and you've done your research on me. Anyway, when you were 12 and you had this group, did you think we want to be pop stars and everything, or did you just think we like making music?
That band. It was a slushy band.
We have our ways. If you do get to be famous, how do you envisage it? Like, if you say if your record sold, like, went gold next week, and you suddenly both found yourself with $100,000 in your pocket, what sort of things would you spend it on?
I'd get a fruit machine.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'd have to buy a fruit machine, because I spent... the guys would tell you about this, that I'm addicted to them, I can't get off them. They're dangerous.
He wins money, then he loses it again. He doesn't, like, stop it once he's won it. It's really clever.
Is that it? This whole thing is just so you can buy a fruit machine?
That's it. Yeah, this is why. This is when will I get my fruit machine?
That's it.
What about you, Matt or Luke, whichever one you are?
Luke. I don't know. I'll probably buy some earplugs. I'd have to keep listening to Michael Jackson all the time. I like Michael Jackson, but it's like you get bored of him when you... I think I've listened to every compilation Michael Jackson ever there is.
You're actually the drummer in the group, aren't you? And you're the singer, and you sound a lot like Michael Jackson. Is that on purpose, or is that just the way it all comes out your mouth?
It comes out my mouth, that's right, but it's like...
that's ridiculous.
No, I've listened to him since I was about 7, like the Jackson 5 and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so it's just rubbed off on me, really. You know,
is he one of your heroes?
He's my hero.
Is he?
Yeah, he is.
Give us a little burst, because I know that these guys sound like Michael Jackson, but you probably don't.
You want me to Michael Jackson song, or...?
No, a little bit of anything. Let's hear that Michael Jackson.
So I've learned that love's not impressions.
Right.
Very nice. Now, what if, and having just heard you sing, I'm sure it's not going to happen, what if you don't get famous?
I'm going to cry.
Then what?
We're both crying.
Is that going to be enormously embarrassing for you, going back after the whole kind of hype that you've had about, you know, when will I be famous, all sorts of stuff? Is that going to be
crippling and embarrassing?
I don't think embarrassing. I'd have to give up if this song isn't here.
I think we've had, like, hype. Because we're, I think, like you say, because we're twins and everything, people do think that we are twins, that it's a hype, but we're, you know, we're brothers, that's where we're born. You know what I mean? And we both are into music, and we just, like, that's the way it happened. It's not like, oh, yeah, we're twins, this being a pop band.
Yeah, but there has been all this press saying these are the new WHAM, these are going to be the sound of 88. Well, yeah, but even so, people have said it about you. So if it didn't happen, if you were a complete flop and nobody bought your records and it was all a disaster, would it be awful to you to go back to your hometown?
Not at all.
Some people say they're the ones that failed.
I don't think... I can't really see it happening yet because it's like we've done, this is our second single and we're far from giving up. I think we just keep at it for a while.
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah. It's because, like, I mean, if it doesn't happen this time, we're just taking the approach for it. We've got plenty of time.
Only 19.
So
you've
got
such
time.
Good skin.
Yeah, so have you actually.
It's not as good as you.
No, oh, it is.
I was 8 years older than yours or something.
All right, Mum.
Have you ever given it any thought as to what it will actually be like on a day-to-day basis with things like mobbing? I mean, if you do...
We thought about it.
Yeah, it'd be great, do you?
It'd be a laugh, yeah.
Have you had any of that already?
Yeah, we have.
What, going down the street and girls going,
oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, we have.
Yeah,
well, can you imagine what that is going to be like 24 hours a day with girls ripping you clothes?
Oh, it's going to be terrible.
Wet paper suits, wet ones. Wet paper suits.
Yeah.
I think it would actually be terrible. Yeah, I honestly can't imagine it being fun.
I mean, I might get a bigger clothes budget then. I might get more clothes.
No. Do you think all that will be real good love?
Yeah, great, brilliant. I can't wait.
What about touring? Now, I know that you just call me Mum and it's all very funny and you walked in and sort of looked just like your auntie. Yes, very musical.
No, but our auntie is three years older.
Yeah, yeah, okay, anyway. But I know I'm older than you, but I have... Hang on. No, listen to me, I'm doing a talk
sorry,
at this
yes.
bit.
Sorry.
But I have, in the past, toured a little bit. And I know what it's like, and it is incredible.
You've toured?
Yeah, I have.
Yeah, incredible.
Just a little bit. Yeah, you don't have to sort of set me up for it. But it is awful. I mean, it is very, very lonely, and you get very miserable. Have you thought about that side of it at all?
No. I don't think we'd be lonely.
No, because, like, we just have such a grin when we're out together. We have such a laugh.
Do you?
Yeah, it's crazy. It's a good laugh. So we won't get bored or, like, lonely, no.
I can't imagine us getting lonely on tour.
We've got three of us, plus we've got a lot of mates getting over there as well.
You don't think you've got a slightly idealistic view of what the whole pop scene's going to be?
No,
like?
No way,
far
definitely
from
not,
that,
definitely
we,
not.
You know, we don't have an easy time. We haven't had exactly an easy time so far.
Yeah?
No.
I read something in the papers which said that you, in your music, you don't think like there's any room for politics and drugs and AIDS and all that sort of thing. Is that
no,
right?
we actually write about some of our tracks have got because we've written a whole album already, and like we've written a track about AIDS and like politics as well. But I don't think you should actually say, listen, this track is about politics and you've got to listen to it.
I think
if you can make music's like the light-hearted thing in life, and it should be fun, and it shouldn't be heavy. You should just listen to it and enjoy it. You shouldn't have to listen to the statement.
I don't agree with mixing politics so blatantly, obviously, that if you start, I think it becomes a bit brainwashing then, because the young kids are listening to it. It's a bit, I think it's just brainwashing. Yeah.
You don't think it's quite a useful way of putting messages
it's not, well. If they want to get into politics, let them do it externally, but music should be released from everything, I think.
There we go. The Bross Boys have brains after all. Yeah. You have obviously been called pretty a lot, which kind of you can't really deny because you both are dead pretty and everything. Do you reckon that's going to be a help or a hindrance? Because it could actually mean that although, you know, it's like lovely and you're going to get your pictures pinned up on every kind of school locker from here to, you know, Scotland, people are likely to label you as kind of vacuous pretty boys. Is that going to be a problem, do you think?
I think it can help in many ways. As you say, it will get us on... We'll get some of our pictures pinned up and everything, but it can also like be a hindrance as well, because it goes against you in the fact that they think, because as you say we are pretty, like they think that's the only thing you're good for.
Yeah.
They don't think you can sing, they don't think you can play your instrument, but like
it works for and against, like I say, I think it works for us in both ways, because they're only going to say we can't do it all, you know, we're just pretty faces. Well, I'd rather have pretty faces than ugly faces. And when they say we can't do it, we can prove them wrong quite easily. So it's not going to be a problem.
We'll deliver.
Then we'll deliver it.
It must put terrible pressure on you, though, for things like if you ever get a spot and stuff like that, people just aren't going to like that.
Yeah, I'm thankful for the cover.
I like it.
This one here.
One here as well.
Covered it up.
Do you wake up every morning going, please, God, let me know how spots today?
No, I say that before I go to bed. Don't wake up in the morning.
No, drink lots of water.
Is there any rivalry between you? Because you are twins, and you must have had that all your life, isn't it?
Yeah,
that old gag, we've had that one. Yeah, but is there, honestly?
No.
No, they say, do you share the same girlfriends? But who'd want to share your own girlfriends?
if you both fancy a girl, is there one of you who tends to get them and the other one doesn't? Is one of you more successful?
I think if we both like and then we give up.
We're both not interested.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Is he the honourable third?
See, what we hate is when a girl says, oh, I want to go to one of the twins.
I don't mind which one
it
is, just one of you.
One of the twins. Yeah. No, at school. It's not so much now, but at school, and they used to say, oh, I want to go to one of the twins. We used to go,
that's nice. It makes you feel really special.
It makes you just feel, you're just like, at school, you tend to be, when you're twins, you tend to be like one person. They don't look at you as, but I broke my wrist once, and they said, oh, where's your bandage?
You had a brace, wasn't it once?
I had a brace, and they said, where's your brace, Luke? They don't, you know. And the worst comment we've ever had is like, how does your mum tell the difference?
Yeah, right? That's the worst.
How does she?
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't have to answer that. There is a third member of your group, Craig his name, and he plays the guitar, doesn't he? Is there a lot of rivalry? Because you two who are going to be getting all the press. I mean, it's you two that I've got in bed with me now, not Craig. Does Craig mind?
He's depressed about that, actually.
Is he?
Yeah,
he's really down, actually. We don't know if he's here. Is he still alive?
No, he's really depressed about that. No, but not at all. He's more
because the people who assume that he's going to be the odd one out. Because it's two of us.
And they feel sorry for him. But no, we're like really close. Really are close.
Are you?
Because he's not a twin, he in a way, he gets more noticed. You see what I'm saying? He gets like, he's fans out. He's a good fall for the band.
So you hate him?
No,
he's the one
I love
gets
him.
All
he's
the
brilliant.
Attention.
No, he's brilliant.
Was he in Caviar all those many years ago as
no,
well?
No, he wasn't.
He's in a rock group called Stone.
Yeah, Stone.
It's been very nice indeed having you.
Likewise.
I've enjoyed it very much. Did you have a nice Christmas, by the way?
Yeah, brilliant. Brilliant.
Did you get any good presents? What did you give him?
I bought him a sort of like stereo head system thing.
Strange.
What did he get me?
What did you get you?
He didn't get me anything.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Never mind. Very nice to have you here. Thank you very much indeed. And jolly good luck with your sort of and all that sort of gear. And I hope you do extremely well and all that sort of stuff. That's all from Pillow Talk for now.